वेलकम बैक टू अवर चैनल रेस्पेक्ट एजुकेशन। नाउ लेट अस सी थ्योरम 8.7, दैट इज इफ अ परपेंडिकुलर इज ड्रॉन फ्रॉम द वर्टेक्स ऑफ द राइट एंगल ऑफ अ राइट ट्रायंगल to the hypotenuse, then the triangles on both sides of the perpendicular are similar to the whole triangle and to each other. So here let us draw a suitable diagram for this statement. Here let us understand the question, that is there is a right angle triangle. For example, here let us take ABC is a right angle triangle. Let us join AC also. So consider ABC be a right angle triangle, right angled at B. Right. If a perpendicular is drawn from the vertex of the right angle, means from here, from B, a perpendicular is drawn to the hypotenuse. Here hypotenuse is AC. So from here, let us draw a perpendicular. Name it as BD. Here angle D is also 90 degrees. Right. Then the triangles on both the sides. Means first one is triangle ADB is the first triangle. And a triangle CDB is the second triangle. These two triangles are similar to the whole triangle, and also these two triangles are similar to each other. Clear? So let us write, before entering the proof, let us write the given condition. Here given triangle ABC is a right angled triangle. Triangle ABC is a right angled triangle in which angle B is equal to 90 degrees. Now BD is drawn perpendicular from B to the hypotenuse AC. So BD is perpendicular to AC. Now here what is to be proved, that is to prove these two triangles are similar to the whole triangle. That means this first part we can say, part one as triangle ADB is similar to triangle ABC. First triangle is similar to the whole triangle. Similarly second triangle is also, let us set the second target, that is triangle CDB is also similar to triangle CBA, or we can say triangle ABC. So here CDB is also similar to, we can write CBA, of course both are same. So these two triangles are similar to whole triangle. And third one, also these two are similar to each other. That means triangle ADB is similar to triangle CDB. This is what we need to prove. Now here let us start proof. So here I would like to tell you an easy way to complete its proof. Here you see, you just imagine triangle ABC as father triangle. Just keep in mind, triangle ABC, just imagine this triangle as a father triangle. Right? And triangle ADB, you can remember this as first son. And triangle CDB, this as remember it as second son. So here what are we going to do? First we are going to prove first son is similar to father. This is the first target. And the second target is second son is also similar to father. That is the second target. And as the first son and the second son both are similar to the father, that is the reason these two are similar. That is what the third one. So in this order we are going to prove it now. So this is just for our understanding. Okay, just keep in mind so that this theorem will be, this proof will be little bit easy to understand. So now here, first let us take first son and father. See here, first son and father. So here, if you observe carefully, you just move, see, father means A, B, C. You just imagine yourself that you are moving in the triangle A, B, C, A, B, C. First son means A, D, B, A, D, B. If you observe carefully, here you are covering angle A in both the times completely. I repeat for you once again. See, triangle ABC, triangle A, you start from here, A, B, C, again you close it. That means here you are covering complete A. Of course, here you are covering C and B also. But when we compare with the first son, means A, D, B, in this you see, this part is not covered. This part of B is covered. C is not at all covered. That's why here, but angle A is covered twice. That can be taken as common angle. Right? So here, let us separate father and first son. So from triangle ABC and triangle ADB, father and first son. So here, let us draw ABC and ADC also. Right? As I have told you, angle A is common in both the triangles. That is the reason here, this place I have given for both. Means both the places are given for only A. Since A is common, angle A is common, it indicates that angle A is common in both the triangles. This triangle refers triangle ABC. This triangle refers triangle ADB. Right? Here you see, this A, here the place, this place is given to A, so we have used A here. Here also we have used A. Now these two places are given for B and C. These places are given for D and B. Now let us see how to adjust them. Here you compare once again. In triangle ABC, angle B is 90. In triangle ADB, angle D is 90. So here, this 90 degrees place can be given for B in this triangle, and this place is given for D in the small triangle. Means in father, B occupies this place. In the first son, D occupies the corresponding place. Because here B and D both are 90 degrees. So here, the place for B is given, the place for D is given. Now here what is left? C is left. So here we can write C here. And here B is left, we can write B here. So that we have given places for A, B and C. Here also A, D and B. So this is how we can separate the triangles. That is the whole triangle, or here we are calling it as father triangle, to the first triangle, means we are calling it as first son. Now here we are going to prove these two are similar, means these two triangles are similar. How we are going to prove? Let us see here. In these two triangles, angle A is equal to, in this also angle A, this is, since it is common angle, it is a common angle in both the triangles, this angle is common. Same way, in this triangle angle B and in this triangle angle D is equal to 90 degrees each. So these two, it's a pair of angles, this is also a pair of angles. So by AA similarity, by AA, angle, similarity criterion, we can say triangle ABC is similar to triangle ADB. See here, the first part of this theorem, we have reached the first target, it is completed, right? Now the second target, we are going for the second target. here let us see. Now father and first son, that is over. Now father to the second son. Here father means triangle ABC. So here I am taking from triangle ABC and second son is CDB, triangle CDB, right? Actually here I have changed it into CBA. I will tell you the reason why I have changed. Here ABC can also be taken as CBA. Of course this is father only, this is father triangle only. We can say ABC or CBA also or CAB also, however you want, you can say, no problem. But particularly in this moment, why should we write CBA? That I will tell you now. Here CBA, just move your journey from C, B and A. Just try to imagine that you are revolving in this region CBA. Again CBA, right? When you come to the second son, here I am writing you, this is the first son, this is the second son. When you come to the second triangle, means second son, in this is a CDB, again CDB. If you observe carefully, in both the triangles, angle C is common. That is the reason here, first in place of C, I have written C only. That's why instead of writing ABC, I wrote CBA. Right? Now here, let us draw two triangles. One is father triangle and another one is second son's triangle. So here this is A, B, here labeling is to be given. So here let us give the labeling. This is for triangle CBA and this is for triangle CDB. As I have told you, we are covering angle C in both the triangles. So here this place is given to C. This place is also given to C. And here, in the father triangle or bigger triangle or whole triangle, angle B is 90. So here angle B is 90, in this angle D is 90. Right? Here places are given for C and B. Here C and D. Now the leftover place that is given for A, so that CBA completed. Here also this place is given for B. Now let us compare these two triangles. So in this angle C equal to, in this also angle C, this is, since it is common angle, it is common, and these two, it is a pair of angles. Same way here, in this angle B is equal to, in this angle D, this one is equal to 90 degrees each. This is also another pair of angles. So we can say by angle AA similarity criterion, we can say these two triangles are similar. Triangle CBA is similar to triangle CDB. If at all you want to write it ABC, it's not all a problem. You just tilt ABC, then BDC will come, nothing more than that. So here for your convenience, I'm writing that also. Triangle ABC is similar to triangle BDC, that's all. Here you have to take enough care that C should coincide with C, 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 B should coincide with D, B, D and A, B. Here also you followed the same, you see, A coincide with B. See here A to B, same here also, A plus is replaced with, means it is, for A the corresponding angle is B, right? Here for B corresponding is D, here also for B corresponding is D. For C here corresponding is C, here also for C corresponding is C. So we can say these two are same only. That's why here with this our target 2 also completed. Right. Now here we are going for the third one. This third proof you just observe, we are, nothing is here to do. We are not going to do anything here. Very simple. This you take as equation number 1. It can be taken as equation number 2. From 1 and 2, we conclude this third one. See, first son is similar to father, means they both look alike. Of course, same shape but different size. Second son also is similar to father. At the same time, these two also, they both are similar. That is what here we are going to prove. Here you observe, for triangle ABC, this ADB, these two are similar. For the same triangle ABC, BDC also similar. So from 1 and 2 we can say which is here equal, ABC, ABC equal. So let us keep it aside. Now here triangle ADB similar to triangle BDC. With that this proof gets completed. So here let us write from 1 and 2, from equation 1 and 2, triangle ADB means first son and triangle BDC second son, both are similar to the same triangle ABC. So let us write here from 1 and 2, triangle ADB, this is similar to triangle ABC. From second equation, triangle BDC, this is also similar to triangle ABC. When these right hand side parts are equal, then we can say these two are also similar. Therefore, triangle ADB is similar to triangle BDC. Clear? So here you see we wrote ADB and CDB. CD is the BDC. So here ADB is similar to BDC. So with this, this third part of this theorem also gets completed. So that here we can say that if a perpendicular is drawn from the vertex of the right angle of a right triangle, means from B, that is BD, okay, to the hypotenuse, means to AC, then the triangles on both the sides, means here this first triangle and second triangle, ADB and CDB, both the triangles are similar to the whole triangle. See here, both are similar to the whole triangle. Here whole triangle is ABC and also to each other. At the same time, they both are similar to each other also. With this, this theorem 8.7 gets completed.